we're practicing taking derivatives here in this quiz. First problem, f of x is x squared times the square root of 4 plus x plus the natural log of x cubed. First thing to realize is you've got a sum of two functions. So you've got to take the derivative of the first function and add the derivative of the second function. That's a linearity property. For the first function, you've got a product, x squared times the square root. So you need the product rule. Break it down step by step like this. You've got your left function and your right function. Moreover, notice that your right function is the same as 4 plus x to the 1/2 power. So you'll need the chain rule too, although in this case, the chain rule ends up being kind of trivial because the derivative of the inside function, 4 plus x, is just 1. If it were 4 plus 3x, for example, the derivative would be 3 and it would not be trivial. So the product rule says, you know, left d right plus right d left. Left x squared, d right, take the derivative of 4 plus x to the 1/2. Use the chain rule, bring the 1/2 down, plug in the inside function, subtract 1 from the exponent, and then multiply times the derivative of the inside, which is just a 1. Again, since it is just a times 1, you really don't have to write it. Left d right plus right, the square root function, d left, the derivative of x squared is 2x. With the derivative of natural log of x cubed, there's a couple ways it can be done. Probably what most of you did is use the chain rule. The inside function is x cubed, the outside function is natural log. The derivative of natural log is 1 over the input. The input is the inside function, x cubed. Multiply times the derivative of that inside function, though. And you can leave your final answer like this. Now, do notice this one simplifies. This is the same as 3 over x. Is there another way that could be done? Yes, because you could also have used a property of exponents in this problem, or property of logarithms, to write that as 3 natural log of x, right? That power, that 3, can come down in front of the logarithm, and the derivative of 3 times natural log of x is 3 over x. You do get the same thing either way, as you would have to, because in math, things are consistent if you don't make mistakes. Next problem. H of z is 5e to the sine of 4z plus e cubed. E cubed is just a constant. Its derivative is 0. There's no z in there. Okay, its derivative is 0. So the only derivative we have to focus on is the derivative of this part. The 5 is a constant multiple. It can stay out in front. I really have a composition of 3 functions here. In e to the sine of 4z, the most inside function is 4z. That's what gets done first when you plug a number in for z. You multiply it by 4. Then you take the sine of it. That's the middle function. And then the outside function is e to the x, say. So how do you do the chain rule with 3 functions instead of 2? You take it step by step. The most outside function, again, is like e to the x. The derivative of e to the x is e to the x, so I get e to the, not x, not z, but sine of 4z. But then the chain rule says multiply times the derivative of that inside function, sine of 4z. But I need the chain rule again for that derivative. Sine of 4z, the derivative of sine is cosine, so I get cosine, plug in the inside function, 4z, multiply times the derivative of that inside function, 4. Done. Yes, you can simplify this if you like. 5 times 4 is 20. You can't simplify it much beyond that. But it's fine to leave it like this, too. Next one is 4 arctangent of x cubed plus inverse sine of x. Remember I said in my note, my message, arctangent is the same as inverse tangent. We do want you to know that, so we do use different notations sometimes on these quizzes and get the gateway. This would be the same as if it were a tan inverse. The derivative of inverse tangent, question, I said its derivative is zero. There's no variable there. It's a constant. The derivative of inverse tangent of x is 1 over 1 plus x squared, right? Now there's a 4 there, so the 4 has to stay there. I'll put it in the top of the fraction. 1 plus x squared, but it's an x cubed inside the arctangent function here. So it's the x cubed that has to get squared. Then multiply times the derivative of x cubed. If you did simplify that part of it, it would simplify to x to the sixth, but you don't have to simplify it.
We'll be on the gateway.
You do not have to simplify it in the gateway either. Inverse sine has a derivative that's memorized to be this. And it would be the same answer there if I wrote an arc sine instead of inverse sine there. If you meant sine of x to the negative one power, you would not write this. This is all by tradition. You would write cosecant of x if you meant that, or sine of x with inside parentheses quantity to the negative one power. We're stuck with traditional notation that's sometimes confusing. And this is relevant for the next problem. G of y is y cubed cosine of y plus secant of y. I did happen to remind you that secant is the reciprocal of cosine, cosine of y to the negative one power. Notice the parentheses there. You're not going to be reminded of that kind of thing on the gateway. You need to know it. For the first part, I need the product rule, lefty right plus righty left. Left is y cubed, d right is the derivative of cosine is negative sine of y here. The variable's y. Do notice I put parentheses around this. Many people forget the parentheses here and they maybe forget a dot. And it makes it look like y cubed minus sine of y, but that's wrong. So you would have to have for sure the dot and ideally the parentheses too. Lefty right plus right cosine of y d left. Derivative of y cubed is 3y squared cosine of y. With the derivative of secant of y, there's a couple things you can do. You can either use a memorized derivative of secant, which we actually haven't talked about. It happens to be secant times tangent. Or what most of you probably did was that you took the derivative of this, either by differentiating that with the quotient rule or by differentiating this with the chain rule. It simplifies to the same thing in the end. If you differentiate 1 over cos y with the quotient rule, low d high minus high d low over the square of what's below, start with the low. That's the most common mistake is people mix up what goes up on top in the order. Low d high, well, d high is 0. Derivative of 1 is 0. Low d high minus high d low, the derivative of cosine is negative sine over the square of what's below, which you can write with a 2 there, if you like, or cosine of y parentheses squared. Why does it equal this? Well, the negative signs cancel. You get sine of y divided by cos squared y. That is the same as this because this is 1 over cos y times sine of y divided by cos y by definition of secant and tangent. If you differentiate it based on that formula with the chain rule, you get negative 1 cosine of y to the negative 2 times by the chain rule negative sine of y. And this is the exact same thing as this. Finally, the last one. Oh boy, yikes, that's scary looking. Sine of, really? 2x minus 1 over 3x plus 2. It's a chain rule problem. The inside function is the fraction. The outside function is the sine function. The derivative of sine is cosine. Plug in the inside function and then multiply times the derivative of the inside function for which we need the quotient rule. Tracking with me here? Chain rule first, derivative of sine is cosine. plug in the inside, then I need to differentiate that inside function, but it's a quotient, so I need the quotient rule. Low d high minus high d low over the square of what's below. Done. Yeah, you can simplify that fraction. It's probably best not to, because you might make a mistake. On the gateway, all we're testing you on is your differentiation, not your simplification. So don't simplify. 25% of the time, you'll make a mistake if you do. Even if you've got the right answer here. These rules, in combination like this, are pretty amazing when you think about it. Can you imagine finding f prime with the limit definition of the derivative? I don't think so. I don't think I'd ever want to do that. I'm serious. I don't think I'd ever want to do that. So don't. Use the rules. They're very powerful, especially in combination. Question?
Yeah, so for the gateway, you want us to just leave it.
You just leave it like this, yep. We're just just take all necessary derivatives for the gateway, and you're done. Make sure parentheses are where they should be and not where they shouldn't be. You got to understand concepts. Low d high, for example, I'm multiplying the entire low function times the derivative of the top. I got to have parentheses there because it's the entire thing being multiplied by that. As one example.